adding two vectors, scaling a vector, and subtracting a vector are basic operations that one can easily visualize in a picture. We're now going to talk about an operation that's going to be very important as we start looking at more complex operations in linear algebra later on. It's hard to picture though. It's known as the axpy operation, and it takes a vector, scales it, and then adds it to another vector. Given two vectors x and y of size n and a scalar alpha, the axpy operation is given by y is equal to alpha x plus y. So what are we doing here? We're taking vector y, we're adding a scaled version of vector x to it, and we're then assigning the result of that to vector y. So, more specifically, y becomes alpha x plus y. We expose the components of x and y. We notice that alpha times x just means scaling each of the individual components of x, the result of which now needs to be added to vector y. And therefore, each of the components of y is simply computed as a scaling of the corresponding component of x added to the component of y. Let's do an example. Here we have two vectors of size 3. We do 2 times the first vector, adding it to the second vector, the result of which is negative 2, 4, 2, if we just scale the first vector, which then must be added to the second vector. And the result of that then is adding the first two components here, minus 4, adding the second components, 7, and adding the third components, minus 1. This operation is known as an axpy. Where does this come from? Well, these kinds of vector operations have been very important since the 1970s, and back then the language of choice in this area was Fortran 77. Fortran 77 had the limitation that variables and subroutines had to be identified with at most 6 letters and numbers. So they had to be somewhat innovative about how to name operations and subroutines that implemented them. And the axpy here is simply an abbreviation of alpha times x plus y. So it stands for scalar alpha, the a, times x plus p, y, axpy. If we now want to look at an algorithm for performing this operation, notice that the ith component of y has to be updated by scaling the ith component of x and adding it to the ith component of y. So psi I becomes alpha times chi I plus psi I. And as usual, we need to put a loop around that so that this is done for all components from 0 to n minus 1. In summary, we've just introduced the axpy operation, alpha times x plus y, and we will see that the axpy operation is going to be a foundational operation. It will recur over and over and over again as we go through our course.